Welcome to the Acupuncture Outsider podcast. My name is Richard Hazel, and in the time it takes for you to commute to or from work, I hope to have shared something of interest about orthopedic acupuncture using motor points, trigger points, myofascial slings, neurofunctional acupuncture, segmental treatments, anything that crosses my mind that seems to be of interest. I hope you'll enjoy it. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Acupuncture Outsider. This is Richard Hazel. Today I want to talk about pseudo-sciatica caused by an entrapment of the superior gluteal nerve. And I find it interesting because from clinical experience, I knew that many times treating gluteus medius would make sciatica go away, and I never really understood that. I had assumed that perhaps there was some sort of segmental sensitization that would cause an irritation in the sciatic pathway from the gluteus medius, but I never really understood what was going on. But I was reading Dr. Trescott's chapter on the superior gluteal nerve and pseudo-sciatica, and when people have it, it often happens after some sort of trauma with a forced internal rotation and extension of the hip, sometimes auto accidents. They'll have that impact injury that internally rotates the hip and extends back. That could happen as a driver bracing for impact, in front. So the assumption is that forced internal rotation irritates or causes a contraction of the piriformis, which can lead to an entrapment of the nerve. So the pathway, the superior gluteal nerve, comes from L4, 5, and S1, and it enters the gluteal area from the greater sciatic foramen just superior to the piriformis, right above it, and then it passes underneath the piriformis on its way through the gluteus medius and minimus on its way to the TFL. And it's mostly motor. There is apparently a sensory tract that goes deep toward the femoral head, but mostly it is a motor nerve. And apparently, when it has some injury, and injury to the superior gluteal nerve can also happen by intramuscular injection. In fact, that's a very common injury that can happen. So the symptoms could be a pseudo-sciatica, hard to sit on that side, hard to put weight on that side, hard to stand. And it usually goes down just to the back of the knee, not always to the foot. Sometimes it can go to the foot. Most of the time, the pathway is just through the hamstring area, through the glutes and the hamstring. So be on the lookout for that. The other, what should I say? The other issue that you're going to see from this entrapment is weak abduction, weak hip abductors on that side. So you'll see the Trendelenburg sign with the drooping opposite hip. I think there are probably different levels of entrapment where you get into that much weakness. I think there are people who just have the pseudo-sciatica, and you're not going to necessarily notice a big discrepancy in the weakness unless in the abductors being weak, unless you're doing some manual muscle testing. I don't think they're necessarily you're not necessarily seeing it in the gait as much as you do when there's a huge discrepancy. However, it's good to know that that's why that is happening. Apparently, when the nerve comes out of the greater sciatic foramen, it can get entrapped between the piriformis and the gluteus medius. And then there could be some edema because of the entrapment. And then there's more pressure and it builds. And then you're going to see weakness. And because that superior gluteal nerve innervates the gluteus medius, the gluteus minimus, and the TFL, there's really nothing left to stabilize the hip once you have that entrapment or injury. So it's an important thing to look for, and you can palpate that entrapment zone right below the PIIS, in right above the piriformis, where the piriformis is going to be attached to the sacrum. So there's a little triangle there you'll feel. And that is a very common entrapment zone. So pressure there will elicit some pain if there is an entrapment there. And you can treat that area with a needle. You can get a really good motor nerve stimulation there with electric stim that will move all the muscles together. So if the patient is lying prone and you put a needle in and you stimulate there, not only will the glute medius fire, but the hip will internally rotate because of the TFL and the glute min abducting and internally rotating. So that's how you know you've got that good branch of the superior gluteal nerve. So I thought that was interesting. And by the way, the inferior gluteal nerve comes out below the piriformis and then goes upward over the piriformis. So there you'll have innervation of the gluteus maximus, and you'll have innervation of some of the deep rotators, the gemellus muscles, the obturator internus, and the quadratus femoris, I believe, are all innervated by that lesser gluteal nerve, just so you know. I just thought it was interesting that entrapment of the superior gluteal nerve can cause a pseudo-sciatica. I was not aware of that. And now it makes sense. It's always interesting to learn something like that and then look back at old cases and think about how you thought you fixed it because of one thing and then realizing that you fixed it because of something else. And thinking about the people that I saw even in acupuncture school clinic where treating just the gluteus medius eliminated sciatica. And, you know, at that time, I didn't really know enough about deep gluteal syndrome to have even examined an issue with the deep rotators. So just gluteus medius was sort of my go-to for back pain, and I probably did what I knew I could do, and it helped the sciatica. And now I think I know why. It wasn't really some sort of sensitization at the segment that was causing that. It was more likely the entrapment of that nerve by the piriformis. Though it is interesting to think, it is possible that the irritation of the superior gluteal nerve could be sensitizing at the L5-S1, and then you get the dorsal root reflex where this sensitization at that segment starts to send motor signals down the afferent sensory sciatic nerve. So possibly something segmental would irritate the sensory part of or maybe the could be clunial nerves or something that are feeling sensitized, that feels like sciatica. I really, really don't know. But it is an interesting thought experiment. Like, how does this happen? How do you get sciatic pain from a motor nerve that innervates abduction? And again, it could just be edema, and maybe the edema puts pressure on the sciatic nerve, but the origin of the problem is the superior gluteal nerve entrapment. Not sure. But anyway, that's what I was thinking about. And, if you're interested, look at, Jay Shaw, J.P. Shaw, SHAH. Look at his research on spinal segmental sensitization. He wrote a lot that's publicly available on the internet about spinal segmental sensitization and how trigger points can cause it, and how resolving the trigger points is not usually going to suffice because of the spinal segment that's sensitized. And then also he will explain that dorsal root reflex. It's really fascinating when you start seeing how the body responds to things, to pain, and how it can generate more problems. So getting better educated on those sorts of things can help us to better address sensitization. You'll see in your chronic pain patients. I was just talking to somebody else recently about that. Like, the acute injuries seem so easy compared to chronic pain. Chronic pain is just, it's so much more complicated, and you're always going to feel like you're not quite, like you don't quite know enough, because you just never can know enough. But as you do learn more, you do have more and more success. So you do see your success rate going up, but there's always going to be somebody who has a case that you just can't figure it out, because it doesn't match up with either motor nerves or sensory nerves or cutaneous nerves sometimes you're just going to see things that do not make sense based on how you know the human body is laid out. And that's okay. Eventually, hopefully, we look back on those cases and we know what was wrong and what we should have done. Sort of like how I look back, 12 years at people with sciatica where the gluteus medius motor point resolved it. It's interesting. So anyway, I guess it's kind of a short episode, but I wanted to talk a little bit about that because there's something I was just reading about, and it was of interest to me, and maybe you too will find it interesting. And if you do a little Google searching, there's a lot you can find about the superior gluteal nerve and entrapment syndromes and things like that. Okay. Hope you have a great week. I will talk to you soon.